What's going on, guys? So I promised an update video. Not a whole lot, honestly, has gone on with the city. Mostly just been kind of adding minifigs, kind of try to populate the city a little more. And in doing so, I've kind of started to add we've got some funny things going on, like, you know, Hulk's getting some pizza and stuff like that. But I've also been trying to add kind of Easter eggs. So I got like Mando here with the Baby Yoda, the child, Grogu. And then just other stuff like I got the monolith here. And all the guys running away, all scared what it is. We're still working on the building, the round one. I'm showing you actually probably more than you've seen because it didn't have the tiles on the floor. So I will start working on the fourth floor here really soon, and then we'll do kind of an update on that, kind of some other stuff that other than the tile and the minifigs. There's a couple other things with that building. But yeah, I've just been, like I said, just adding kind of funny things, and Easter egg, or kind of more like a scavenger hunt also. So I'm thinking about putting up like a little list on the wall or something, and then just have people look, you know, see if they can find Bigfoot, or see if they can find Waldo, or Rick and Morty, you know, or the Ninja Turtles, or, you know, stuff like that, you know, Yoda with the seagulls, or Rob Ross painting a happy tree. You know, I won't tell you everything. Maybe counting Batmans, because there's probably about 3 or 4 Batmans in the city right now. So, we got the Beatles crossing. So, like I said, I won't tell you all of them in this video. Kind of try to keep it maybe, kind of keep it fun, and like kind of maybe also keep it changing. But just, like I said, maybe I'll do like a list. One of the other things that I have been working on, not the city, is I got the Lego Sith art pack. Well, I got 3 of them to make the big Vader. So I'm not sold on that spot. I mean, it looks good. I just was trying to find a spot. The wife told me, no, it can't go upstairs in the house. So I, you know, was looking around in the room, trying to find something that was kind of far away, because I want to force you to be a distance away. Cause when you're up close, these things just don't, you know, you can see just each Lego piece, and it's not as jaw dropping or anything until you get back away. So, the bottom of them, I mean, other than his buttons on his chest, and you're kind of covered by Ninjago City, so I might look for a new spot. I had, on this wall here, I had like a TV. This was like before the city really became a city, and it wasn't being used, so no one in the city watches TV, so I took the TV down, but I'm going to probably put another wall mount of some sort. And I'm going to mount the Millennium Falcon, I think, on that wall, and then add like a light kit so you can see the blue light shining out the back. I figure that'll look really cool. What else do we have for updates? I know one. So on my video game side of my basement, I got all kinds of stuff. That's where I put the Nintendo, and then some of the guys we got there. But the I had leftover pieces, a lot of pieces from the Sith art pack, the Vader. And so I was like looking at maybe making more projects, and I came up with this idea. So my daughter has this color by number kind of app on the iPad or whatever. And so I just did a quick search, and I was like, how about Mario? And I pulled up a Mario one. So it didn't have the clouds. It didn't have the, you know, every tile
on the whole 32 base plate. But it did have, you know, the actual Mario in his cape. And then the colors were very similar. I think I changed one or two. But for the most part, it was, yeah, I think his face was kind of a pinkish color, but I used the tan. And I might actually change his glove. I don't know. I have to look at some pictures. I might go with a white or something. The gray don't look. But from a distance, just like the Sith one, it looks great. I like it a lot. It turned out really good. But yeah, so I just did that. I just, you know, loaded the pattern or the instructions basically from her app. And then I just did that on a base plate. So that turned out really good, I think. So the Mandalorian Baby Yoda, I have the ones from the Razor Crest. I had those in the city, but those ones were like kind of a fake knockoff ones. I know, you're not supposed to do that stuff, but it just, I don't know, the little pod just looked so cool. So until they make one like that, I'm going to keep it in the city. but yeah, that's pretty much it. I really haven't done a whole lot, honestly, Lego-wise. Just been having a lot of other projects and stuff keeping me busy. But I do plan on getting the new police station. So I'll have to make some room for that. I've also got a bunch of other little stuff that I'm still working on. I'm still working on kind of like combining some of the smaller sets together to make like a big modular maybe. But regardless, we're going to have to make a spot for the new police station. I don't know if I'm going to shrink the park down a little bit and try to scoot some stuff down, maybe kill some of the beach or something. Not really sure here, because I mean, we really don't need kind of two beaches. I'm also planning on doing, instead of the fabrics, maybe I'll get some base plates, you know, stuff like that. But anyway, just like I said, I wanted to do a quick update. I wanted to show you what I have been doing. I promised you I would do that. So mostly, like I said, the big Lego Darth Vader Sith, adding some little things to the city, not really any big changes to buildings or anything like that. I have not really worked too much on the round one. I started looking at lights. So I got that one light in the loot box or whatever it was. And I put it in here. It works pretty good. So basically just lights up underneath the train station there. So, but that is kind of, I was already thinking about it, but it really sparked my idea to start lighting every building. So I've been looking at doing that. Definitely not going to do them all at once. I'm thinking maybe I might start at the bookstore and just kind of work my way down the street and then back up this one and then start doing those back ones. But basically, yeah, just a building at a time. I think that'd be really cool to have some lights. And then some of these custom buildings, those three there, are going to all have to have a custom light set to it or something. I'm wondering when I might pick this building up here. That might be the easiest. I don't know how that police station will look. If it'll, you know, if it has decent side pieces to it. I know it's got the banner, the advertisement for the Brick Bank laundromat there, the Suds. So, I mean, it might look okay. We'll play with some ideas when we get it. I'm planning on getting it as soon as I can, if I can even get it before January 1st, if they do like a VIP thing, which I don't think they will, but if they do, I will get that. But anyway, like I said, just enough rambling, I guess. I just wanted to show you what we're working on here. And then, like I said, we'll pick up here soon on that and possibly the lights light up, maybe a light video. Each video will do like one building or something. So, and then plus other little projects I'm working on. So we should see some videos coming here soon, guys. Yeah, here's another building I'm working on. So I'm still working on the hospital. I'm still working on round one. I'm still working on Spider-Man's apartment. And then I started to kind of put a couple sets together for that Toy Store set that was not a full modular. It's kind of like the city buildings or whatever. I think it's the 3-in-1 is what it is, actually. So working on that. I'm going to have to get some more pieces. Might have to pick up a third kit, or I don't know which one will be cheaper. Just buying individual, you know, pieces here, or actually buying, you know, another set or two. But it's coming along. So that's another thing I'm working on. But anyhow, we will talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.